This is the application for Aura Frames. No matter what frame you have, this is the app that you will be utilizing. It is more fully featured than their web interface, which is really just meant to upload things to the cloud. This will allow you to not only upload, as you could see here, add photos, but do some other things with the frame itself. First and foremost, you have your activity feed right here. And here you could see I uploaded this video right now. It tells you who did it. And then if I scroll down, here we have date, photos that were added. There's a three dot here, which will allow you to remove these photos just like that, which in actuality was a little easier than it should have been. There needed to be another dialog box there, in my opinion, just from a user interface standpoint, because those photos aren't part of my photo frame anymore, which is a shame because I like those. So now I have to go back and add them. Here we could see you have comments as well as send some love, and it will let you know on this particular date the amount of photos that you uploaded. It's not the date that the photos were taken, it was the date that they were uploaded. I can select send some love and then choose an icon, like there we go. So the other person, if they uploaded it, would get a notification. I can do a comment if I want to. That's all done through here. If I come down to the very bottom, I select add photo. I can come through my photos on my phone or I can select other options. So here there's the scan a photo. Here are albums that I currently have on the phone. I linked it up to Google Photos so I can always go and pull from there. It's not the easiest interface to do when you're digging into Google Photos. So the easiest way is actually if you have the photo on your phone already and just send it up. To the right of the activity, we have photos. And this again is going to be all the photos that you've uploaded. You can see over here, I've uploaded 256 photos. It's not in chronological order. It's in the batch that you upload them in. So here we can select. And if I select something, I can then do next. And then I can include in slideshow, exclude from slideshow, and then remove from frame. These could be part of the frame itself, but I don't necessarily want them showing up on the frame because we're uploading all this stuff to the cloud. We're going to come back to activity because that was my buffer to keep people out that didn't want to be in the video. To the upper right hand corner, we have this notification bell. And here you can see this picture got some love, meaning somebody tap a heart icon on the frame itself, and that's where you get a notification of. If I select a photo, it will bring up the photo. I can tap into it, and then from here we have some options. So I can share this right from here, and your selection methods would come up. I can position. So let's say that this was a landscape. I wanted to make it more horizontal. I have some options to fiddle with. I can change it from portrait to and rotate and then save. I'm not going to do any of that, but the editing things are right there. And then if for whatever reason I wanted to, let's say I have my photo frame right there, I can select show now. And what this will do is force this picture to show up on the photo frame, and we're just going to give that a second so it actually does. There you go. And it forces that picture that I selected to show up on the photo frame. And I also just tapped the heart button for this particular image. So if we come back to the main screen, momentarily that will pop and let me know, hey, somebody liked your photo. Over here on the left, if I select this, it will show me my account information, lots of private information, not going to show you that. And then frames. So I have my personal frame that's sitting on my work desk. But if I add new frames, I can have other locations, I can have other people's frames. I would simply select their frame and then I could add pictures to their frame right from this interface if I wanted to. Coming up to the upper right hand corner, if I select this, this is our settings. From here in the upper right hand corner, our three dots, we have help FAQ, enter gift claim code, or turn into a gift. So if you have a gift or want to turn your frame into a gift, that's how you could do so. Here we have the ability to edit my frame's name. Down here, add members. Simply by selecting this, I can add other people. So I would select the plus sign and then I pick their contact information. You have to put in their email address. Notifications, well, I have notifications turned on, but we have frame activity and then smart suggestions. So this will push, hey, these are pictures that we think you'll enjoy. Under slideshow, we have timing. I have it set for every 10 minutes, but you can go as low as 15 seconds or as high as up to 4 hours. Photo order, you have shuffle or you have chronological. So there are dates that your photos were taken, which is part of the metadata, but not always utilized. I can select chronological and then it will go in chronological order. I have it currently on shuffle. It does tend to favor some pictures a little more in this particular setup, but that's how I have it. Here we have photo background. Fill is what you saw when I had the tree picture. it fills it in with color from the picture itself. If you select black, it will just do black borders around a picture when you have it in portrait mode, because the frame itself can only display landscape. Next, we have autoplay video. You have on or off. So if you don't want a video automatically playing on you, you turn that off. I will say that the video itself might automatically play. However, the audio will not play unless you tap it. And then here we have photo match. This is kind of some under the hood science that they're doing where they'll try and put pictures together, especially if you have the option for displaying two portrait photos next to each other. What this will do is, hey, the colors are similar, the people are similar. That's generally what I've noticed with it. Here we have device on off. I have it on auto, meaning it will use the light sensor and then turn itself off. We have a schedule. If I set up a schedule, I can set an on time and an off time and then time zone and then select save. We're not gonna do that because I like auto. Speaker, well, you've got speaker volume. Anything that you've heard so far has been at this volume. It's actually pretty decent for the size of the speaker and its location. Remote control, well, here we go. I can utilize my smartphone as a remote. I can choose to exclude this photo. I can change its position and I can change the photo. So right now I just tap this and two new photos popped up, which I don't want to show. And I can change the volume and timing of the slideshow. So we're just gonna bring that back in focus. Sorry about that. Told people I'd keep them out of the video. So is what it is. Coming down, we have language, English, German, and French as your written language here. And then your Wi-Fi credentials. You also have email photos to frame. If you select this, it will show you the email address so that people, if they don't have an account, but want to send a picture to the frame, that's the email they send it to as an attachment, and it will add it to the frame. And as I mentioned before, right up here, if I select that, well, guess what? I got a heart on that picture because I accidentally touched it while I was showing you how to use things. But that is everything that we can do for the Aura frame using the Aura app.